5 सेकेंड स्टार्ट. दिस बिल हैज बीन ब्रॉट फॉरवर्ड फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ अमेंडिंग द 2004 एक्ट विच ओरिजिनली अप्लाई टू पार्ट ए स्टेट हाई कोर्ट्स बट आफ्टर द रीऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैज बीन सो अडेप्टेड एज टू मेक इट एप्लीकेबल टू ऑल द हाई कोर्ट्स इन द प्रेजेंट स्टेट्स. Formerly, so far as the then British India was concerned, we had the order of 1937 under the Government of India Act of 1939. The Debt Act or the order was in force as appropriately amended or adapted from time to time. Then you are aware that the constitution was passed and according to the constitution certain rules were laid down both in the body of the constitution itself as also in one of its schedules. So certain conditions of service was specified as, for example, the question of the remuneration of the High Court judges and the Chief Justices in the various High Courts. But some matters remained and therefore in 2004 an Act was passed by Parliament. So far as the then part A state high courts were concerned. Before that, sir, you are aware that after the integration of states, we had under the constitution what was known as part B states and there were high courts therein. So far as these high courts were concerned, an order was passed in 1983 governing the conditions of service of the Part B State High Court judges. Subsequently, after the reorganization of states, you are aware, sir, that advantage was taken of the amendments to the constitution in certain respects so far as the high court judges were concerned and those amendments actually came into effect from 1st November 2006. Thus, you will find, sir, that from 1st November 2006, we have the High Court Judges Act of 2003 duly adapted after reorganization. That is the main act, or as it is sometimes called, the Parent Act, which is now sought to be amended in respect of certain matters. One is with regard to leave, and it is considered necessary to specify certain circumstances. The second is about the making of some of these rules applicable to additional high court judges because a special provision was made in the Constitution by the 7th Amendment. Now, in this bill, it has been made clear that so far as these acting judges and additional judges are concerned, their service as such will be counted for the purpose of pension only if they are subsequently made permanent judges. Otherwise, for example, if no such provision was made, then their service for the purpose of pension would be counted only from the time they are made permanent. But here it has been made clear that in case they are made permanent, their previous service as an acting or additional judge will also be taken into account for the purpose of their pension. So far as leave is concerned, whatever leave they would be entitled to in view of the period of service that they have put in as acting judge or additional judge will be taken into account, and under the scheme of leave as mentioned in the Act of 1984, they would be entitled to a period or periods to leave as then laid down. Then, sir, after this, a very important question arose so far as the unexpired leave was concerned, as also the question of the pensions of the former Part B State High Court judges who were continued as judges in the new high courts that were established on the reorganization of states. We had some high courts, as you are aware, in Part B states. When under the Constitution, these Part B states themselves ceased to be as such and they were placed in the reorganized states of India, naturally, the high courts in Part B states also disappeared. So far as these judges were concerned, a very large number of them were ultimately appointed as judges in the new high courts under the States Reorganization Act, and naturally a question arose as to what is to be done so far as the period of service that they had previously put in the Part B State High Courts were concerned. A question arose as to whether the period of service that they had put in as a high court judge, including in some cases as chief justice, should or should not be taken into account, or whether some other formula should be introduced by which a particular period and not the whole period should be taken into account. In this connection, two questions arise. One is about leave. If, for example, they were entitled to certain periods of leave and then by the time the new high courts came into existence, they continued in effect to be high court judges, what was to happen to the unexpired leave period?